द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 1375 बल्ब्स व्हिच इज थर्ड. सो देयर इज अ रूम विद एन बल्ब्स नंबर्ड फ्रॉम 1 टू एन अरेंज्ड इन अ रो फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट. इनिशियली ऑल द बल्ब्स आर टर्न्ड ऑफ एंड एट द मोमेंट के वी टर्न ऑन द लाइट के बल्ब एंड द बल्ब चेंज द कलर टू ब्लू ओनली इफ इट इज ऑन एंड ऑल द प्रीवियस बल्ब्स आर टर्न्ड ऑन टू. So what we have to return is the number of moments in which all the turned on bulbs are blue. So let's have a look over the example number 1. In this, the off condition would be represented by the white color, on by yellow color, and if all the previous bulbs are switched on along with it, so it would be represented by color blue. As the initial condition is given that all the bulbs are switched off, so it will have a color white. Now, the as given array, the first bulb to be turned on is 2, so it will blue with the yellow color because the previous bulb is not switched on, so it will not have the color blue. Now, the second element is 1. So 1 would be switched on and all the previous elements are switched on, so we have to color them blue. Now when we are turning on the third bulb, the condition for coloring blue is satisfied. So in this condition also the color would be blue. But when we are switching on the bulb 5, the bulb color for 5 would be yellow as 4 is not switched on yet. So we have to calculate when all the bulbs are turned on. So we can see here that in the moment 1 it satisfies the condition, in the moment 2 as well, and in the moment 4. So the total moment when all the bulbs are blue is 3. So we have to return answer 3. Now let's have a look over the approach for this question. So in this, what we have to do is initialize a variable max with the max value, which is initialized with 0 first, and with the array I. So we have to calculate the maximum of max variable and the array I. In the first condition, the initial value for the max was 0 and array 0th element is 2, and we have to check if they are equal. If the condition satisfies, then we have to increment the count variable with 1. Now in the second condition, as the max value is changed with 2, so we are going to check 2, comma the next element in the array, which was 1. So in this condition, max value changed to 2, and this is the ith plus 1th value. So these are equal, so we have to increment the value with 1. In the third condition, as the previous value for max was 2 and the next element for the array is 3, so the max value is 3, so we have to check with the I plus 1th value and increment the count as it is equal. So here count value incremented to 2. Now in the fourth condition, again checking max, comma the next element in the array, and it will return 5, which is not equals to 4. So the count value remains to be 2. In the last condition also, the max value remains to be 5, which is equal to 5. So incrementing the value of count. Now let's have a look over the code for the question. Now first we have to initialize max with 0 is was given in the equation, answer with 0 and count with 0 as well. Now iterating over the array and changing the max value with the maximum of previous max value and the next element in the array. And then incrementing the value of count and checking if count is equals to max or not. If count is equals to max, then we have to increment the value of answer, else return the answer at the end. Now let's have a look if it runs for the cases or not. And now let's check by submitting the code. So yeah, this is accepted, and here is the code for the question. Thank you.